We're gonna be late.
Child Protective Services, can you please come to the door? I need to speak with you. Major Ibarra.
Yeah.
We're here regarding your brother. May we come in?
Who are you two?
I'm Jessica Loya. I'm your niece Gabby's teacher. I've been her teacher for about 2 years.
And I'm Armando Reese from Child Protective Services.
Wait, what are you two doing here?
Hasn't your family contacted you about your brother Jason?
Contacting me about what?
I'm sorry I have to be the one to tell you, but your brother... Well, a few days ago, your brother, he...
He what?
He took his life a few days ago.
Are you okay, Mr. Ibarra?
You should have a seat. Excuse me for a moment.
I know this is a difficult time for you, but the reason we're here is your niece Gabby. Her guardian is temporarily her grandmother.
Step.
I'm sorry, Will.
Dawn is her step grandmother.
Yeah, Dawn, Mrs. Williams, she mentioned it was complicated.
It's not complicated. My dad had Jason with his first wife who passed. Then he married Dawn, cheated on her with my mother, and had me.
I see. Yeah, Gabby's father sort of told me about the family at school meetings, and I mean, some people say I have a tendency to get too involved.
Well, then don't. I'm sorry.
Mr. Ibarra, in these extremely difficult situations where we're strapped for time and resources, we met with Mrs. Williams, Dawn, this morning. She made it clear that at her age, there's no way she's taking care of your niece.
Well... I mean, and she didn't seem suitable. She was drinking wine at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Look, your brother in his will stated he wanted you to be his daughter's guardian. We'd like to keep families with each other for all possible.
Honestly, I barely know her. I met her for the first time a few days ago. And prior to that, I hadn't seen my brother in 15 years.
But Gabby's a great girl. And I know her father was sick, but he saw something in you. Sometimes what we need is the unexpected.
She's in Mrs. Williams' home right now. That's where her father and her stay for the time being. If you decline, she goes to a group home. Look. There's no other option.
So, if I say yes, then she's in my custody just like that?
Well, there's a processing period where we can remove her if we see her unfit. Or you can send her back if you can't manage. It's your choice. Give me a call when you make that decision.
Her mother died during childbirth. Her father just killed himself. Her own grandmother doesn't even want her. You're all Gabby has left. So I just hope you make the right decision. Have a good day, Mr. Ibarra.
That's crazy. You gotta decide today?
Yeah, soon as possible. Thing is, I don't know that I'm ready to take care of another life, and especially after what my brother just did.
It's heavy, man. You said she was cool, right?
Yeah. I only met her the once, but she was great.
Then what's the problem?
Yeah, easy for you to say. Look at my life. You know, things are falling apart. You know, I ain't got shit together. Job sucks.
No,
get all you want, man, but she needs you. It's that simple.
Where are you going? Aren't you gonna help me figure this out?
Real shit. It's not complicated. The universe has given you an opportunity. You get to be there for Gabby like your parents weren't for you. I gotta get to work.
Right. Yeah, all right. Mr. Reese, this is Peter Barra, Gabby Williams' uncle.
So you're supposed to go live with this guy you don't know or go to a group home. What about your grandma?
She said she can't keep me. Apparently my dad was a lot of trouble, and at her age, she's too old to raise kids.
What a bitch. Screw this. We can get a place. I have like $500. We could get a ratchet little spot in Hollywood and it'll be totally cute.
Thanks for the offer, but I don't think child services will be cool with that. Maybe this guy will be different. I mean, we listen to the same music and he seems pretty cool.
You're right. I mean, you get to move from the boring valley to Hollywood. Hey. How are you doing about everything else? You know, your dad?
I'm fine. I don't know what people expect me to say. Miss Boy is in my face talking about my feelings, and I'm just like, it's fine. He's gone, and it's fine.
Yeah, but you found him, and it wasn't like some random accident.
Brenda, I'm fine. Really.
Just remember, because your parents are gone and your grandma sucks, doesn't mean you don't have family. If your uncle sucks too, you can come live with me and my mom. Cool?
Thanks. Don't worry. I'll be fine. Really.
Okay. Hey, you better take care of my best friend or I'll kick your ass.
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
So, this is all the paperwork I'll need back. I'll make a visit real soon. What you're doing for? It's a good thing.
Yeah, thanks. I just hope I'm the right guy for the job.
You are.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Gabby. Brenda.
Hey, I have a question for you. Are you gonna switch your schools? Ripping her away from all she freaking knows and loves? Sweetie, take it down a notch. Well, Pete, can Gabby stay in my class, or does she have to go to a school closer to your apartment?
I don't see why she needs to switch schools, but she's gonna have to take the train to the valley.
You'll be with her though, right?
Yes, I will be with her for sure.
You two better get going if you're gonna make that bus. Remember, you can still lose her. So if you're gonna do this, don't fuck it up.
Silence from the siren sound.
Small, but dirty.
It's okay.
You can take the bed, and I'll take the couch.
Yeah, the couch is cool.
new roommate.
Nice.
I mean, I don't know what I'm doing. The website says you're supposed to get these kids to talk, right? But she doesn't seem to want to talk to me.
It's only been a few weeks, bro. Give it time.
Yeah, but in those few weeks, I haven't been out once. Angel won't answer any of my phone calls. There's little girl shit all over our apartment. Her over-involved teacher, Miss Loy, is all in my ass.
At least she's hot. I know, not the point, but what are you gonna do? Send her to live in a group home?
I mean, I don't know. Look, I'm just thinking. If I talk to Dawn, right? Get her to see that it'd be better for Gabby to go live at her place.
Good idea, bro. See if a drunk who kicked you out at 15 and refused to take in a 13-year-old after her father just committed suicide for some reason changes her mind.
Grown up. What do you want?
I just came to talk. Confused. Why didn't you keep Gabby after Jason died?
It's none of your business, and I'm not going to answer any questions you have. Now get the hell off my porch.
What? You still have issue with me? You kicked me out after my father's funeral.
You are lucky that I kept a roof over your head as long as I did.
Look, I couldn't help who my mother and father were, and Gabby sure as hell can't either.
Oh, your father, he made his choice. With your no speaking to English whore of a mother.
Don't talk about my mother
that
way.
Yeah, and then for Gabby, who the hell knows what that is?
I don't even know why I came here.
Yeah, why did you come here?
Because she needs somebody. She grew up in this house. How can you turn your back on your family that way?
Jason was my stepson. They both lived here rent-free while he worked out his demons. I paid my dues.
This is how you honor the memory of your husband, huh? By treating his family this way?
His family. Do you know how it felt? To devote your life to someone, and how do they pay you back? They have a kid with another woman. I raised two kids that weren't my own. What did I do to deserve that?
I don't know anything about raising a kid.
You think I'm gonna raise a kid at my age? Mm-mm, done raising kids. No, not gonna screw up another kid. He's gonna go kill himself.
You had nothing to do with that, okay? Jason was sick.
How do you think he got that? Well, hey, thanks for the trip down memory lane.
That's good, Don. You should keep feeling sorry for yourself, because that's gonna make everything better.
You know what? He's better off dead.
What the hell did you just say?
Your brother is better off dead. Because he would have ruined Gabby's life like his father ruined his. Yeah. I don't know if you noticed, but the men in your family don't have a great track record. So why don't you just give her up now before you screw her up too?
Thank you.
For what?
For helping me see that I need her, and that it took me seeing the wrong person to know that I'm the right one.
You son of a bitch. Do you know what I did? Do you know what I did for you? Do you know what I did for you, son?
That's insane. She said that?
Yeah. You know, and I mean, I guess she had a point about my dad, but that comment that she made about Jason?
That was too far. I don't want to say I told you so, but
I know.
I told you so.
I know. I know. What is that, Rob? I'm like super high right now.
Mexican swag. It's called, Are You a Mexican?
or are you a Mexican cat?
Mexican cat, that's good. Speaking of cats, the other day I saw this video online. I want to show you. The cat jumps, and when he jumps, the song Sail plays. It's hilarious. You gotta see it. Shit. Is that the right time? I'm an hour late to pick up Gabby from school.
Pete! What about the cat?
Pulled a piece of his lace off the wall. So now I'm sure of it. That is like that, so I don't talk back. Don't stop staring off the maniac in the mirror.
Jessica.
What?
Have you seen Gabby? I looked everywhere.
She's not with you? School's been out for 2 hours.
No, I know. Look, I went over to her grandmother's and I lost track of time. I was supposed to meet her in front of the school.
Why did you go see that woman? What the hell were you thinking?
I don't know, okay? The more I think about this, I'm not the right person for this. I don't know what
I'm
doing.
Damn it, Pete! That woman gave you nothing! She gave Gabby absolutely nothing! I can't believe you. I should call Mr. Ruiz.
No.
Gabby doesn't need this. She's been through enough as it is. She needs someone that's going to be there for her. Not someone that's going to give up as soon as things get hard.
I know, okay? Please. Look. I fucked up, all right? I'm sorry. Will you please help me find her? She's not answering her phone. I keep calling.
You're fine. Get in the car. She's probably at your apartment.
She's here. It's fine.
It's not fine.
Gabby, what were you thinking? Coming all that way by yourself on the metro? You could have been kidnapped.
You were super late, so I came home. What else do you expect me to do?
Hey, I expect you to wait for me. You didn't call or answer your phone? What you did was so irresponsible and dangerous.
Get out of my face, Pete. I'm not going to listen to a lecture about responsibility from a 30-year-old dishwasher.
Well, regardless of how you feel about me, I'm all you got.
Why do you even care? You barely know me.
Barely know? You're my niece. I'm your uncle. Of course I care about you.
I heard you talking to Bobby the other day about me on the rooftop. I'm sorry I'm so much trouble. Why don't you just send me back?
Because you're all I got. Look, I will be the first to admit that things were easier before you and your dad came into my life, but easy is just another word for empty, and I don't want to live like that anymore.
Why would my dad leave me so easily, but you won't?
It's not easy for your dad to leave you, okay? I don't know, maybe he knew that we needed each other. I may not be your father, but I'll always be here for you.
Thanks.
We're gonna be okay. I don't know how, but we're gonna be okay.
Hey, blame all the same. I appreciate you came, but my love for you was measured in the war. Story told overall, still my mix against the world, and no more. tall overall, still my back's against the wall, and I